University of Delaware women's basketball team was struggling. The Hens were 0-3 in conference play and seemed too young to be able to snap themselves out of their funk. But then came a trip to Northeastern and a dramatic second half come from behind win, which sparked 5 wins in their last 7 games. And all of a sudden, Delaware welcomes Northeastern to the Bob tonight with a chance to get above 500 in conference play for the first time all season long. Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Bob. I'm Matt Janis. This is Delaware basketball on Hens All Access as UD, entering at 10-11 overall and 5-5 in the conference, takes on Northeastern. The Hens trying to build upon the momentum of 2 straight wins, and as I mentioned, 5-7 overall. Last time out, they beat Hofstra on the road thanks to the dramatics of Erica Brown. She had a career-high 31 points and was just incredible in both halves, 17 at the break and then 14 in the second stanza. Brown saying after the game it was the most points she had scored at any level of basketball in her life. For her effort, she was named CAA Player of the Week. Evidently, it was a good day to be a Delaware point guard, as Jody Sawyer, the redshirt sophomore, also enjoyed a stellar day. She had 9 assists, the most by any Blue Hen in more than 2 years. Meanwhile, for this Northeastern team, it has been a rough first year under new head coach Kelly Cole. They have just 1 win in the conference so far and 1 win on the road, but they are led by Samantha DeFries, who comes in 6th in the conference at just under 14 points per game. She can shoot the ball from the perimeter and get the ball to the basket off the bounce. She'll be someone Delaware has to watch, as will Francesca Sally, who had a double-double the first time these teams matched up back in January in Boston when she had 16 points and 12 rebounds. It's Delaware and Northeastern coming up for the Carpenters Center in Newark. We'll be back with all the action in a moment, but first, we'll turn it over to public address announcer Kevin Linton with the starting lineups.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, let's meet tonight's starting lineups. First, as we welcome and introduce the visiting Northeastern University Huskies. Introducing first, at guard, 5'11" freshman of Walford, Vermont, number 32, Maureen Taggart. At center, 6'2" sophomore of Denver, Colorado, number 33, Francesca Sally. At guard, 5'9" junior of Lenham, Maryland, number 10, Anthony Stewart. At forward, a 6' junior of Bergenfield, New Jersey, number 23, Samantha DeFries. And at guard, 5'7" senior of Air Force, Playback, Canada, number 1, Betsy Mercier. Coaching staff for Northeastern University Director of Basketball Operations, Cash Canada. Assistant coaches are Yanuet Adenatula, Jill Lester, Chris Passport. Ladies and gentlemen, first season by DC University and coach Kent Cole.
Coach Jeanine Green. And ladies and gentlemen, in her 19th season at the University of Delaware, the head coach,
timeout against William and Mary. And the center is Francesca Sally, who had a double-double when the Hens and Huskies first matched up, 16 points and 12 rebounds. Head coach at Northeastern, Kelly Cole, in her first season, her 11th overall as a head coach. Meanwhile, for Delaware, the normal starters, the Hens have Erica Brown at the point, joined in the backcourt by Courtney Green. At the small forward, it is Hannah Jardine. Power forward, freshman Makeda Nicholas. And the center is Joy Caracciolo. Delaware on the home, white jerseys, blue numbers. Blue yet letters spell out Delaware across the chest. Yellow trim on the numbers. Northeastern, the black jerseys, white numbers, white letters. Northeastern in caps around the chest. And they have red trim. Hens will go from left to right in this first half for the Carpenter Center, where we are underway. Delaware wins the tip. Makeda Nicholas tapping it into the hands of Joy Caracciolo. And Delaware goes to the attack first. It's Brown on the left wing, backing up in front of the Northeastern bench, picking up her dribble and passing out near center court to Courtney Green. Right hand bounce towards the lane. Flares back to the wing. Up top to Caracciolo. Good head fake, driving to the lane and banks one home. Lefty floater kisses through, and Delaware on the board first. 2-0. 19:34 left in this first half. Hens have been red hot offensively. They have scored 70 or more points in three of their last four games, something they had done just once over their first 17 contests of the season. Here's Mercier going to work off the dribble, driving to the lane, leaving it off to Taggart near quarter. Cross-court feed, right wing to Stewart. Stewart up top to Mercier, dribbles towards the lane, passes inside, it's tipped away and stolen. Nicholas the deflection, Jardine the steal, feeds it forward to Brown on the run, into the lane, floats it, too strong off the window, and then steals the rebound away from Sally in tight, but misses the point-blank lefty bunny. And this time Northeastern controls the rebound, secures it, and brings it forward the other direction. Taggart at the top of the key, left wing chest pass over to Stewart. High post lob to DeFreeze, backdoor dish opposite wing to Sally. Sally into the lane, floats it, too strong off the glass. Rebound, Caracciolo outlets it forward to Erica Brown. Brown angling towards, again, the Northeastern bench, left side of the floor, looks to trigger the offense. High screen comes from Nicholas. Top of the circle, hesitation move, and the runner banks home. 4-0, Delaware leads, and that's one of the shots that's done so much damage of late for Erica Brown. Getting into the lane off the bounce, at hesitation move seems to freeze defenses, and she reads it so well. Here's Northeastern with the ball, down 4-0, 1:50 into this game. With it right block, open inside, it's DeFreeze. She does not shoot it, kicks it out instead to Mercier. Near baseline, dish goes over to Sally, back out, and a three is good. Mercier connects. And it's 4-3, Delaware's lead cut to 1. 17:53 left of the first half. Mercier, someone Delaware will have to keep an eye on. 35% three-point shooter on the season. The senior out of Quebec in Canada. Green the other direction for UD. Still the Hens' leading scorer. Dribbles towards the left side of the lane. Lobs it left elbow to Nicholas, who head faked and then walked before she put it on the deck. Turnover gives it back to Northeastern. And a couple subs in for the Huskies. Returning, or coming in rather, for the first time, Tanisha Hopewell, and also Elise Mark. Mark coming off the bench, has been a starter most of her career. Matter of fact, she started the first 11 games of the season for Northeastern, but off the bench here over the last couple of weeks. Mercier running point, gives it to Mark right wing. She's double-teamed, gets it into the middle of the floor to Taggart. Taggart dishes right block to DeFreeze. She lost it, got it back, kicked it outside to Mercier. Mercier with 12 of the timers straight away. Right elbow dish goes to Taggart, head fake. Now puts it on the deck, picks up her bounce, lobs it near wing, open three, Mercier rattles home. And a couple of trays has put Northeastern on top, 6-4. Their first lead comes just under 3 minutes into this game. 17 remaining in the opening half. Brown again turning the corner with a right-hand bounce, backing up to the wing. Foul line feed to Nicholas. Nice dish, right elbow to Caracciolo, who lost it. It's stolen, and then a tie-up as Hopewell sprawled to the deck, grabbed it, and Caracciolo reached in to at least force the arrow back Delaware's direction. But Northeastern basketball, 16:41 remaining in the opening half, and Huskies on top by a score of 6-4. I'm Matt Janis, Phil Lehman back at our Newcastle studios. Lauren Carra with the evening off. Delaware trying to get to 500 overall in the year at above sea level in conference play. They're 10-11, 5-5 in the conference, and have been shooting up the CAA standings. Entering the night, they're just a half place or half game behind fourth place Elon and one game behind third place Hofstra. But remember, they have the tiebreaker over the Pride because they have swept the season series. So right now, all things considered, when you start 0-3, to be back where Delaware is, pretty good accomplishment. Going to be tough to catch Drexel, who's three full games clear of Delaware, plus beat the Hens the first time the teams matched up. And, of course, JMU looks to be far and away the best club in the conference this year at 9-0 in league action. And officials' timeout here as they were trying to reset the shot clock to 30, and it ticked down to 29. Officials came over, conferred, and they actually put a couple of ticks back up on the game clock to 16:46. So Northeastern ball on top, 6-4, with a little momentum. Morning Taggart with it right wing for the Huskies. Far corner feed goes over to DeFreeze. Cross-court dish back to Taggart, near corner. Triple's good. And Northeastern has hit three straight trays. And as a result, a five-point Northeastern lead on a 9-0 run. Here's Brown the other way. Hens need an answer. Brown top of the circle off the pick and roll. Lobs it inside Caracciolo. Back out to the foul line. Nicholas gets the shooter's roll as she drills a 15-foot straightaway jumper. And that ends the 9-0 spurt. It's a 9-6 game. Here's Northeastern the other direction. 16:08 left first half. Far corner with it. On the dribble, DeFreeze. DeFreeze feeds it up top, Mercier. Near corner again, Taggart, same spot. This time can't hit the three. Great weak side rebound corralled by Joy Caracciolo. Outlets it forward to Erica Brown, looking to push. Defense is back. On the secondary break, finds Nicholas, who hits the baseline jumper. Left side of the floor, Northeastern didn't get out on her. Nicholas has that range, and Delaware back to within one. So a 4-0 start to start the game, followed by a 9-0 Northeastern run, and now four straight points from the Hens, pulling them back to within one. Here's Taggart, left wing, feeding near quarter with a ball marked. Mark lobbing it between the rings outside of Mercier. Right wing dish over to DeFreeze. Far corner to Taggart. Good ball movement here from Northeastern. 10 on the timer. Off the dribble, it's Mercier. Shot rejected off the help side defense of Nicholas. Here's Brown the other way. Outlets it forward to Green. Green, far corner, baseline drive. Now spins back to the perimeter. Lobs it left elbow. Nicholas, 16-footer off the mark, and then Caracciolo called for the foul. Got a little over-aggressive, trying to battle for the rebound with Samantha DeFreeze. It'll be Northeastern ball when we return. Timeout on the floor, 15-10 left to go in the opening half. It's Northeastern 9, Delaware 8. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
Hello, Delaware fans. This is Coach Brock at beautiful Lums Pond State Park, just minutes from Delaware Stadium. I'm inviting you to come to the park, enjoy their year-round camping, boat rentals, equestrian center, and so much more. While you're here, experience the Go Ape Treetop Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens!
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place yours.
So far, less than 5 minutes in, we've seen four straight from Delaware to start the game, then three straight threes from Northeastern to take a 9-4 edge, and that was followed by back-to-back Makeda Nicholas buckets to close the deficit to one for UD. Northeastern ball out of the media timeout. Jody Sawyer in the contest for Delaware, guarding on the perimeter, Mercier. Forces a feed, left wing to DeFreeze. She drives into the lane, dishes out right wing to Mark. Mark puts it on the deck, blows by the defense, leads it off last second, and DeFreeze lays it home. Great dribble drive and dish from Elise Mark off the bench, the senior from Springfield, Mass. Creating that basket for Northeastern to get the Huskies back up by three. Here's Caracciolo on the dribble, left elbow, hands it off to Nicholas, her 13-footer straight away, can't get the roll. And a nice box out to grab the board. Taggart holding off Jardine. Feeds it forward to Mercier. On the run to Hopewell. Right baseline. Kicks it outside Mercier. Directing traffic, calls out a play. Still 20 on the timer. 14 and a quarter minutes left first half. 11-8 to Delaware deficit. Right wing, it's Taggart. Far corner to Mark. Back up top to Taggart. Taggart gets it inside to Hopewell. Driving on Jardine. Had it stripped all the way out. Both Nicholas and Jardine had their hands active there. Not sure who got a piece of the ball. It's Nicholas that's going to bring it forward as she's unguarded. Finally feeds it off to Brown, left wing. High screen from Nicholas. Turns the corner. Pull-up jumper off the mark. Back rim to 15-foot straightaway. Jay had a rebound for Northeastern. Some one-and-dones here over the last couple of trips for Delaware, who has excelled of late on the offensive glass. Mercier between the rings, far corner mark, up with a three, good. Little late getting out on the back line of the zone. Joy Caracciolo, as a result, timeout called by Tina Martin. I don't think she's in love with the intensity from her defense at the moment, giving it to her team just a little bit. 13:35 remaining in this first half. Northeastern's lead is 14-8. Delaware's given up four threes already, and honestly, almost all of them have come for the corner. Three of the four have been essentially uncontested three-point looks. It's a Northeastern team that shoots the ball for a club that's just 4-16 overall, reasonably well from the perimeter. They're 31% from three-point range. They have four different players that hit at better than 30% from deep. The one player you have to really look out for is Tiffany Montaigne, but Montaigne has not played so far. She has had some injury problems throughout the season. Didn't have any word that she's hurt today, but not playing 6.5 minutes into this game. We'll have to wait and see whether she makes an appearance or not. Here's Sire out of the called timeout for Delaware, bringing it forward for the Hens. Sire running point. Erica Brown being guarded tightly away from the ball. Here's a right wing feed over to Green. Green dishes off top of the circle to Sire. Sire dribbling near quarter. Picks up her bounce. Hands it off to Jardine. Right elbow. Lefty bounce into the lane. Head fake out the defender in the air. Got the angle to release the shot, but couldn't hit. Baby hook straight away. Back rimmed it. Board grabbed by Northeastern. Here's Mercier looking to push. Brown back defensively. Slows the attack. Delaware in a man-to-man defense here. Is Northeastern operating from right to left in this first half. With it, top of the circle, it's Sally, guarded by Caracciolo. Handing it off right wing Mercier. Jab step, put it on deck left hand, driving towards the foul line. Inside to Sally, seals Caracciolo, but can't finish. Too strong off the window with a baby hook. Rebound grabbed by Jardine. Outlets it forward to Brown. Brown lost it on the bounce off her leg. And a turnover will give it back to Northeastern. Sloppy start here offensively for the Hens. They trail by 6, 12:38 remaining in this first half. Initially came out little zone, but have since switched man-to-man since they weren't rotating all that well. Right wing on the bounce, it's Mercier, circling top of the key, handing it off there to Sally. Sally lobs it inside to Hopewell, sealing Sire, and a lefty finish. It's 16-8. 12 and a quarter minutes left in the first half. It's gone poorly here for the Hens, a 7-0 Northeastern run. Right wing at Sire, up top to Green, who can't get a look. Right wing back to Sire, jumper off the mark, offensive board tip by Caracciolo, batted to the outside, and Brown hustles it down. A reset of the shot clock and another opportunity for UD. Sire with it between the rings, on the bounce, calls out the play. They're playing off of her, all over Brown, who gets it right wing. Feeding top of the circle to Jardine. Nice bounce pass entry to Caracciolo, who powers up and misses the lefty finish. Rebound loose on the floor. It was tipped by Sire, but chased down by the hustle of Taggart. Taggart outlets it forward for Northeastern. Gets it to Mercier. Foul line left. Hesitation move into the lane. Kicks it out top of the key. Hopewell. Hopewell surveys her option. Right wing chest pass over to Mark. Mark off a high screen, dribbles right elbow, outside to Sally. Left wing feed over to Mercier, and a 3-second violation will give it back to Delaware when we return. But the Hens in need of some offense. A 16-4 burst for Northeastern as the Huskies up by 8, 11:23 remaining of the first half. We'll be back with more Blue Hens basketball on Fox Sports 1290 at 1410 WDOV in a moment.
Hey fans, 12 and younger, do you want to be a future Blue Hen? Join the Future Hens Club presented by St. Francis Healthcare for invites to exclusive events and free admission to select UD games.
Meet coaches and players like us.
Get your official Future Hens t-shirt and more surprises.
To join, log on bluehens.com with a parent, click on Fan Zone, then Kids Club. Click Register Here, fill out your information, and click Submit.
Join today!
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
allowing Northeastern to hit on 55% of their field goal tries and 4 of 5 three-pointers as a result. Huskies doubling up Delaware at 16-8. Hen basketball out of the media timeout. Erica Brown feeding top of the circle to Makeda Nicholas. Lobs it inside to Jardine. Back out on the perimeter to Nicholas. Hand off right wing Green. Head fake, driving left of the lane, bumped on her way up, and as a result, she will head to the stripe to shoot a pair. Delaware not trying anything from the perimeter right now. Not a single three-point field goal attempt. That's not a huge part of the Hens' game, but right now with the way Northeastern overplaying everything, seems like they're either going to have to get something on a back cut towards the tin or knock down a perimeter jump shot and then try to create off the dribble. Green hits the first foul shot. She'll get one more. Courtney Green, an excellent free throw shooter, 78% on the season, and a junior connects on a pair. Winchester, Virginia native, brings Delaware back to within 6 at 16-10. Northeastern basketball, Huskies bringing it across. Mercier running point, feeding right wing to Taggart. Nice pass inside on the right block, powering up the freeze, and she is tied up by the active hands of Makeda Nicholas. That won't go down as a block shot, but it should. And if it did, it would have been the third block already for Nicholas, the freshman. Active and doing a nice job, helped defensively in this early part of the game. 10 3/4 minutes coming up left in this first half. 16-10 Hens trail. Green with a ball in the forecourt. Near corner to Sire. Left hand bounce all the way into the lane. Looks back to Nicholas on the baseline. One dribble up with a jumper off the mark. And a rebound corralled by DeFries for Northeastern. Feeds it forward to Mercier looking to push. Good hustle back by Green to stop the ball. Feeds it back outside to Taggart. A hand check call. Nickel dimer against Jody Sire. Sire tried for the reach. Got a lot of leather, but a small piece of skin. But called for the infraction. Cassidy Taylor going to come in for the first time for UD. She'll replace Hannah Jardine. Also in for Delaware, Joy Caracciolo returns. As getting a breather is Erica Brown. So the Hens go a little bigger here. Caracciolo, Nicholas, and Taylor on the front line. Northeastern ball, far wing. It's Mark and a whistle away from the ball. Foul call on Delaware. They give this one to Makeda Nicholas. It'll be her first, team's third. Northeastern just one foul. 9 minutes and 42 seconds into this game. 16-10 Huskies lead. On a lob inbound, it goes to Elise Mark at the foul line. One back dribble. Gets herself free, and she hits a 17-footer. Courtney Green got screened off, went under that pick, and paid for it. Huskies back up by 8, equaling their largest advantage of the early part of this contest. Here's Caracciolo in the forecourt for Delaware, dribbling top of the circle, handing it off there to Taylor. Taylor flaring far corner off the bounce. Left elbow to Caracciolo, over right of the lane, Nicholas. Another 15-footer wouldn't go. Mid-range jumper fell early for Nicholas. She's missed 4 straight, though, and here comes Northeastern. Hopewell off the bounce. Dishing off, far corner Taggart for 3. It's good. 21-10, Northeastern by 11. Timeout, Tina Martin. And that's a timeout of frustration. Not liking the energy she sees right now from her defense, which has allowed the Huskies to knock down 5 of 6 threes. And to be honest, none of them have been contested. Almost all of them wide open looks. Hens came out zone early, have switched to man. Nothing going right at the moment for UD. 9:37 remaining in this opening half. A reminder, Delaware basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV. Being brought to you by our friends at the Glasgow Medical Aid Unit. Save time, save money, get well. Glasgow Medical Aid Units with locations in Glasgow, Christiana, and Middletown. Online at GlasgowMedicalCenter.com. 9:37 left first half. Out of the called timeout from Delaware, Hens ball. Tina Martin trying to light a little fire under her team. Taylor and Nicholas to the bench. Jardine and Brown back in. Brown, who had 31 in her last game, just 2 points so far tonight. Sire being given some space on the perimeter, feeding top of the circle to Jardine, who has no space, but creates off the bounce a nice up and under. And a little 13-foot runner gets the roll. And ends back to within single digits at 21-12. What a battle inside as Northeastern brings it the other way. Fighting for position on the block, DeFries and Caracciolo. Good work by Joy to deny DeFries the ball. Right wing bounce, Mercier all over her Brown. Bounce pass top of the circle goes off to Mark. Mark again finds Green going under his screen and makes her pay. 2 times Green has gone under a high pick. And as a result, a knockdown jumper for Northeastern, and they're doubling up Delaware again at 24-12. 8:44 left in this first half. And Northeastern has good shooters. You cannot go under the screen. Nice give and go. Little two-man game, but Sire misses a point-blank try inside. But got a break as Northeastern tipped the rebound out of bounds. It'll stay with the Hens. Fresh 30 to shoot here as Sire will trigger it. Baseline left. Delaware down 24-12. Inbound on the right block. It's Jardine. Powers up. Left-hand finish. Banked it home. Middle of the lane. Off a good drop step. And Delaware back to within 10 at 24-14. Hannah Jardine on the back line as Delaware falling back into that jump zone. Off the bounce. Mark carves up the zone but can't finish. A lefty runner too strong off the glass. And then the rebound batted out of bounds off the hands of Samantha DeFries. So it goes back to Delaware. 8:15 left in this opening half. Hens down 10 and right now just can't get much going on the offensive side. They're 6 of 17 from the floor. They have not tried a three. Trying to get it inside. They do to Caracciolo here. She turns and faces, kicks it outside to Sire. Back to Caracciolo. Powers through a double team. Fires up a shot. Wouldn't go. 10-footer straight away. Couldn't get the bounce. Nobody home to rebound. Northeastern the other direction. Mark a jab step stopping left wing. Lobs it cross court to Taggart. Extra pass. Far corner Mercier uncontested. Foot on the line. Two or three. They'll give her the triple. And it's 27-14 Northeastern, 7:40 left first half. Hens have already called two timeouts, and they can't stop the bleeding. Sire, right wing for Delaware. Left wing feed over to Brown. Inside of the left block, Caracciolo had her shot blocked out of bounds. It'll stay with Delaware, but Hens have to find an answer. Right now, it has been a rough start. 7:28 left of the first half. It's Northeastern 27 and Delaware 14. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
We are the champions. Throw your hands up, welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to BlueHens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
Turning for Northeastern University, 33, Francesca
Selle. Table presented by Exxon and Shell. Delaware, though, doesn't seem like a team that's here live and in person right now. They have not really showed up defensively in the early going. Their ball out of the media timeout. Good entry feed inside. Erica Brown gets it to Joy Caracciolo, who powers up and banks one home from the right block. So Delaware back to within 11. But you look at how this game has unfolded so far, and the Hens just can't stop Northeastern. Huskies shooting 63% for the field, and have hit 7 of 8 threes. But a walk here. I was trying to find the angle for an entry feed was Elise Mark, and she dragged the back pivot foot. That gives it back to Delaware with just under 7 minutes remaining, down by 11, and maybe a chance for the first time since the opening minute of the game to build a little momentum. Sire brings it across the timeline, angling towards the right wing with a dribble, feeds it between the circles to Brow. Left-hand bounce over to that wing, up top to Caracciolo. Caracciolo, with no space, gives it off to Jardine. She turns, faces, shoots, and misses. Got a 16-footer beyond the elbow, front-rimmed it with nobody underneath the rebound, and here comes Northeastern. Sally with the top of the circle, the big hands it off, right wing to Taggart. Taggart, bounce pass, high post, Hopewell. Looks left wing, Mercier, extra feed to Mark. Mark drives baseline around Caracciolo, but can't hit the runner. And a weak side rebound grabbed by Brown. Looking to push, but Northeastern back. Brown weaving left, now right into the corner, near side. Green hits a three. And Delaware back to within 8 on the first three of the game for UD. Courtney Green hits the shot in transition. 27-19, Northeastern's lead down to 8. Big shot from Green. Hens need to get the running game going. It's been a big part of this stretch where they've won 5 of 7 to get back to 500 in conference play. Mark, top of the circle, off the bounce. Left wing feed to Sally. Sally feeding foul line left to Mercier. Mercier calling for some help. Behind the back with a bounce, working on Brown. Up top to Sally, who walked. Not sure why she showed the ball. She's not a threat to shoot the three. All season, Sally has attempted just 18 triples, and she's made only three of them. And yet, she tried the head fake, and as a result, the travel gives it back to Delaware. So it ends within eight, subbing back into the contest, Makeda Nicholas. So the 5-on-the-floor for Delaware, Brown, Green, Jardine, Nicholas, and Caracciolo. Green with it, left wing for UD. Surveys her options, right-hand bounce towards the top of the circle, now drives to the foul line. Bad feed to Caracciolo, but had it knocked right back into her hands. Left wing chest pass over to Green, 13 on the timer. Right-hand bounce towards the foul line, leaves it off Nicholas, not ready to shoot, and now in trouble, kicks it out to Green. Green floats one up in the lane, couldn't get it to go, but got her own miss back. Shuckles to the corner. Great look, left block to Caracciolo, misses the lefty banker, and Northeastern the rebound. Oh, she was wide open. A great feed from Caracciolo. Lob inside to DeFreeze. Fat crowd wanted to foul away from the ball. Brown tying up Mark. A lightning quick jump ball. As Mark tried to put it on the floor, Brown got a piece of leather. And the official calling the held ball. Steph Leon into the game for the first time for UD. She'll replace Joy Caracciolo. Just under 5 minutes left in this first half. Northeastern's lead is 27-19. Inbound goes out near center court to Mercier. Mercier dribbling between the rings. Brown guarding her. Delaware in a man-to-man. Right wing feed goes over to Cassidy Stewart. Stewart up top to DeFreeze. DeFreeze guarded but not closely by Nicholas. Left wing feed over to Mercier. Gets it inside. It's Sally. A reverse layup over Leon. A beautiful finish and the lead restored to double digits for Northeastern. One hard dribble just left of the lane to the opposite side of the basket and then a reverse layup. And now a foul called on Northeastern. A little hand check call against Cassidy Stewart. Thought they might call a moving screen on Steph Leon. But it's Stewart called for the foul. The junior's first and only the second team foul. Just five fouls combined between the two teams in the first 15 and a half minutes. 4:29 left first half. Delaware down 29-19 with the ball. Brown getting the inbound top of the circle. Handing it off right wing to Leon. She gives it to Jardine on a weave type handle. Left wing give over to Green. High post left elbow feed to Nicholas. Puts it on the deck and goes straight to the tin for a lefty finish. And Delaware back to within eight at 29-21. Here's Northeastern beating Delaware back and forcing a hand check foul on Courtney Green the other way. So that'll be Green's first, team's fourth, 4:09 remaining first half. And subbing back in for Northeastern, Tanisha Hopewell. She will replace Francesca Sally. Inbound will come baseline left. They lob it, Mercier getting it into DeFreeze. Her jumper off the mark and then an over the back foul called on a great box out from Erica Brown, forcing the contact from Tanisha Hopewell. And that's Hopewell's second foul, team's third. Leon will go out. And back in Joy Caracciolo for UD. Jardine will throw it in for Delaware under her own basket. The Hens shooting better here lately, up to 36% for the field. More importantly, starting to take away the three-point looks from Northeastern. We're stuck on 8 3-point tries. Unfortunately, the Huskies have made 7. Nicholas driving to the lane, tried a backdoor feed for Jardine, who had it knocked aside. Good defense from Taggart, who looked like she was beat but recovered. It's a steal. Northeastern the other way. Stewart into the lane. Kicking it out top of the circle to DeFreeze. Right wing dish goes over to Mercier. Mercier a jab step. Good entry feed on an angle pass to DeFreeze. A whistle and a walk. Awkward footwork called for steps as she tried to power up, and that'll give it back to Delaware when we return. Timeout on the floor, 3:35 left to go in the first half. Northeastern 29, Delaware 21. This is Blue Hens basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
Rush hour or relax hour? It's your choice. dark. Moving forward.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
.335 left first half. Delaware trailing Northeastern 29-21. And a bit of surprise right now at the Carpenter Center in Newark. It is Blue Hen basketball. They've been down by as many as 12 in this contest. Brown dribbling left wing of the forecourt for UD. Trying to create off the bounce, dribbles all the way right of the lane. Tough angle runner off the mark. And that shot, which has been falling lately for Brown, not today. And here's Northeastern the other direction. Mercier starts left, now right. Angles towards the lane. Dishes it inside to Freeze. 3-second violation called on Northeastern. So the Hens have gotten that call a couple of times now. Tina Martin has been begging for it. Northeastern establishing residency inside the paint on offense. That's the frustrating part right now for Delaware. Much of what Northeastern has created has been either off the dribble or off the extra pass. They have broken down the Delaware defense and then kicked it out off of penetration, which has led to open jumpers. Green off a high screen, dishing baseline right to Nicholas. Low feed to Caracciolo. Great job to recover and power up with a lefty banker. 29-23. Hens back to within six. That was a really tough catch for Caracciolo as the feed came in off her shin. Did a nice job to corral it and then got poised as she went strong with a lefty bank. Here's Stewart the other way, off the baseline. Tough shot, air ball deep. Rebound grabbed by Jardine on the weak side. Brown gets the outlet, brings it forward, stops and pops at the foul line, rattles it home. And that quickly, Delaware is back to within four at 29-25. Boy, this team can strike in bunches. They'll also allow points in bunches, but right now going in the right direction. And a timeout called by Kelly Cole, first season head coach at Northeastern. And she's trying to stop the momentum, which is squarely pointed in Delaware's direction. Remind you that Delaware basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV is being brought to you by our friends at Capriati Sandwich Shop, a proud sponsor of Delaware basketball. Stop in to the Capriati's at Newark Shopping Center or at 4422 Kirkwood Highway to pick up a sandwich today. Visit them online, by the way, at capriati's.com. Delaware down by four, 29-25. Coming up at the half, Bill Lehman will have our halftime report presented by our friends at the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 313, and its local contractors. It's the Energized Delaware at the half. Northeastern ball needing a bucket. Hens have cut what was once a 12-point deficit down to four. Near corner, Mercier again, open three. Delaware late rotating out, but they dodge a bullet as Mercier front rims the triple. It bounces up over the backboard and off the shot clock, and it'll go back to Delaware. So a chance now for the Hens is they have been closing halves strong of late. In my mind, that's one of the key signs of a team that's maturing. Nicholas high post with it for Delaware off the dribble. Works her way into a double team. Great job to hold her pivot foot, but now needs help. Brown comes to the ball, gets it left wing. 10 on the timer. Brown tripped on her way to the basket. No, the official says she fell on her own volition. And as a result, as she slides across the deck, is called for the foul. 88 seconds left to the first half. 29-25. Delaware's deficit down to four. Northeastern with the ball. Brown that time tried that low angling dribble that she's so good at. And just lost her footing. I thought maybe a little collision with the foot of a defensive player. Looked like it was Mark that was in the vicinity, but no, said the official. Sire back in, Brown to the bench, and Sire beat off the bounce by Mercier, who stops and hits a 14-footer just left of the elbow. That is 31-25. Northeastern back up by six. Here's Sire into the forecourt, off the dribble, left wing. Looking inside, gets it to Nicholas. Nicholas, turn and face on the block, picks up her bounce off of two dribbles, dishes outside to Green. Green driving, now backing up off the baseline into the corner. Crossover move. Again, goes baseline. Stripped on the way up. Got it back. Feeds foul line. It's Caracciolo hitting the 15-footer. Green stuck with it after she got stripped on the way up. Kept her vision about her and found a wide open Joy Caracciolo, who pulls Delaware back to within four. 10-second differential. Shot and game clock. Northeastern with the ball. Half minute left in this opening stanza. Delaware crawling all the way back to within four. Right wing Hopewell hands it off there to Taggart. Taggart with a whistle away for the ball and a foul called on UD, and that hurts. Not because it sends Northeastern to the free throw line, but for two reasons. A, it's the second foul on Jody Sire. B, it allows Northeastern to hold for one. Hens going to trust Jody, leave her in. She needs to avoid picking up foul number three in the final 20 seconds of the half. And maybe she didn't do it. Whistled away from the ball. Sire was in the vicinity, as was Nicholas and Caracciolo. Who do they give the foul to? Jody Sager, her third. That hurts. Away from the ball. Can't commit that foul there if you're Sire, who's been such a heady player here over the last couple of weeks. So she'll have to go to the bench with 18 and 2/10 seconds left. And Delaware down by four. The inbound lob up top of the key. It's Mark. Jumper wouldn't go. Rebound batted, and Jardine grabs the board. Bad shot from Northeastern, who could have held for one. Now it's Delaware a chance at the last shot. Brown driving into the lane, kicking it out. Left wing three for Green. Wouldn't go. Weak side rebound. Caracciolo follow. Missed the banker from in tight. Northeastern the board, and we have reached intermission. Well, are you a glass half full or half empty sort of person? If you're Delaware, you trailed by double digits for an extended stretch. You crawled to within four at the break, but had a couple of opportunities to get it even closer down the stretch. As it is, it's Northeastern 31, Delaware 27. Coming up, it's the energized Delaware at the half. Phil Lehman back in our Newcastle studios. It'll be presented by the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 313, and its local contractors. 31-27, Northeastern leads. Back in a moment.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
Cheer more in Baltimore as the road to the Final Four kicks off with the Colonial Athletic Association Men's Basketball Championship, March 6th through 9th at the Royal Farms Arena. A new money-saving fan package includes a room at your choice of hotels, two harbor passes, two admissions to the Power Play It Live Fan Fest, and an option to purchase discounted tickets for the championship. Come for the tourney and stay for the fun. Score your fan package today at Baltimore.org.
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone. 'Cause I'm gonna make this place yours.
It really is a Blue Hen state of mind, and it's all about heading back to Baltimore to defend our crown. It's called March Madness for a reason. Your Blue Hen squad returns to Royal Farms Arena for the CAA Men's Basketball Championship, March 6th through March 9th. So much to see, so much to do. For the absolute best seats available to Blue Hen fans, visit BlueHens.com for more information.
We are the champions, setting it off again. Oh, we on fire, we on fire. Running our own campaign, doing the whole shebang. Oh, we on fire, we on fire.
Get up, stand up, throw your hands up. Welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
Hey fans, 12 and younger, do you want to be a future Blue Hen? Join the Future Hens Club presented by St. Francis Healthcare for invites to exclusive events and free admission to select UD games.
Meet coaches and players like us.
Get your official Future Hens t-shirt and more surprises.
To join, log on bluehens.com with a parent, click on Fan Zone, then Kids Club. Click Register Here, fill out your information, and click Submit.
Join today!
Rush hour or relax hour? It's your choice.
Dark.
Moving forward.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to bluehens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
Of the 2015 CAA Women's Basketball Championship, March 12th to 15th at the Showplace Arena in Upper Marlboro, Maryland. Visit caasports.com for tickets and championship info.
Hello, Delaware fans. This is Coach Brock at beautiful Lums Pond State Park, just minutes from Delaware Stadium. I'm inviting you to come to the park, enjoy their year-round camping, boat rentals, equestrian center, and so much more. While you're here, experience the Go Ape Treetop Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens!
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
We are the champions!
Welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
Ch-
cheer more in Baltimore as the road to the Final Four kicks off with the Colonial Athletic Association Men's Basketball Championship, March 6th through 9th at the Royal Farms Arena. A new money-saving fan package includes a room at your choice of hotels, two harbor passes, two admissions to the Power Play at Live Fan Fest, and an option to purchase discounted tickets for the championship. Come for the tourney and stay for the fun. Score your fan package today at Baltimore.org.
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone. 'Cause I'm gonna make this place yours.
It really is a Blue Hen state of mind, and it's all about heading back to Baltimore to defend our crown. It's called March Madness for a reason. Your Blue Hen squad returns to Royal Farms Arena for the CAA Men's Basketball Championship, March 6th through March 9th. So much to see, so much to do. For the absolute best seats available to Blue Hen fans, visit BlueHens.com for more information.
We are the champions, setting it off again. Oh, we on fire, we on fire. Running our campaign, doing the whole shebang. Oh, we on fire, we on fire.
Get up, stand up, throw your hands up. Welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
Hey fans, 12 and younger, do you want to be a future Blue Hen? Join the Future Hens Club presented by St. Francis Healthcare for invites to exclusive events and free admission to select UD games.
Meet coaches and players like us.
Get your official Future Hens t-shirt and more surprises.
To join, log on bluehens.com with a parent, click on Fan Zone, then Kids Club. Click Register Here, fill out your information, and click Submit.
Join today!
Rush hour or relax hour? It's your choice. Dark. Moving forward.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to BlueHens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
Of the 2015 CAA Women's Basketball Championship, March 12th to 15th at the Showplace Arena in Upper Marlboro, Maryland. Visit caasports.com for tickets and championship info.
Hello, Delaware fans. This is Coach Brock at beautiful Lums Pond State Park, just minutes from Delaware Stadium. I'm inviting you to come to the park, enjoy their year-round camping, boat rentals, equestrian center, and so much more. While you're here, experience the Go Ape Treetop Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens!
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
champion, setting it off again. Oh, we on fire, we on fire. Running our own campaign, doing the whole shebang. Oh, we on fire, we on fire.
Get up, stand up, throw your hands up. Welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
Surprisingly subdued at the break. And you can hear, though, the intensity in her voice, and Della calling two timeouts there early in that first half, wanting to kind of get the attention of their team. And I thought they did a good job. It took a little bit longer than maybe they would have wanted, but they got their focus. They got their energy level raised a little bit, and they got back in this game, and now they have a great chance. First half stats brought to you by RE/MAX. Nobody sells more real estate than RE/MAX. Outstanding agents, outstanding results. Delaware allowing Northeastern to shoot 52% from the field in the first half, 78% from deep, 7 of 9 from 3. They only out-rebound Northeastern by 2, 16-14, but they did do a nice job forcing 8 turnovers, and as a result, Delaware getting 8 more shot attempts than Northeastern, and that's the reason why, despite the fact that Northeastern knocked down 6 more threes, and Delaware only tried 2 free throws as a team, the Hens are down just 4 at the break. Hen basketball to start the second half, moving from right to left, quick touch inside, Joy Caracciolo can't finish, left-hand layup off a great drop step move, and a rebound grab by Northeastern. Here they come the other way, Cassidy Stewart stopping left wing, feeding top of the circle, Samantha DeFries. Right wing dish goes over to Mercier. Mercier dribbling back between the rings. Delaware coming out defensively in the matchup zone to start this second half. It's Sally left wing, feeding it far corner to Stewart. Stewart surveying her options, fakes a pass inside, dribbles towards the top, lobs it that way to Mercier. Mercier right wing to Taggart. High post, Sally wide open, turnaround jumper good. And that's the one spot Tina Martin talked to us about in the pregame. Cannot let the ball into the high post. Delaware did an okay job with that in the first half, but not to start the second half. Too easy for Sally. Northeastern up 6. Delaware the other direction. Brown on the right wing. Up top to Green. Couldn't get space. Curling off the screen. Left hand bounce towards the lane. Powers up. Missed it. Too strong off the window. Weak side rebound to Freeze. Northeastern wants to run. Outlet 4 to Mercier. Stops at the foul line. Kicks it out top of the circles to Freeze. Inside to Sally. Backdoor cut to Stewart. Back to Sally. Circles it outside to Mercier for a reset. Still 17 on the timer. A minute 20 into the second half. Northeastern up 33-27. Mercier, right wing feed over to DeFries. Inside to Sally. Out to Stewart. Thought about a three. Head fake twice. Now drives to the lane. Bumped by Brown. Offensive foul called on Cassidy Stewart. A rather unemphatic call from the official. I thought they were going to call the hand check as a result, but instead they call the push-off on Stewart, which gives it back to Delaware. Stewart's second foul, team's first for Northeastern in the second half. We see an early appearance from Jody Sawyer here, as she is playing with 3 fouls in for Courtney Green. Sawyer dribbling between the rings, handing it off, foul line right to Brown, circling top of the key, left wing now towards the lane, stop and pop jumper, wouldn't go, offensive board, Caracciolo up over everybody to get it, out to Jardine straight away, triple's good, Hannah Jardine hits from deep, the deficit cut in half for Delaware, it's 33-30, but a big tip of the cap there to the senior, Joy Caracciolo, went up for the big offensive board, and a huge second chance converted for Delaware. Now a steal. Nicholas jumps the passing lane and gets a takeaway for Delaware. Wanted to push but couldn't get an opportunity. Instead, slowing it up and finding Sire, who triggers the offense right wing. Entry to Caracciolo. Looks opposite block to Nicholas. Head fake now powering up. Too strong. Offensive board weak side. Caracciolo fouled on the putback try. And Joy going ahead to the stripe to shoot a pair. So Joy Caracciolo, the senior, coming out with energy to start this second half. The big offensive board leading to a deuce, or leading to a three for Hannah Jardine, and now another offensive rebound going to result in two free throws for the BC transfer against this school from Boston, Northeastern University, as Caracciolo rattles out the first foul shot. She's been excellent for the free throw line this season, up to 60% now for the stripe of the year. Hopewell will check out. Or Hopewell will check in, I beg your pardon. Sally will check out. Sally, her first foul, team second in the second half. Northeastern had only three fouls over the first 20 minutes of the game. Second free throw is good. Lead down to two for Northeastern at 33-31. Here come the Huskies the other direction. Mercier, foul line right off the bounce. Crossover towards the top. Low feed, dug out nicely by Hopewell. Left wing chest pass over to Stewart. Stewart drives to the foul line, kicks it out top of the circle to Freeze. Right wing feed goes to Mercier. Great pass to a cutting DeFries, who lays it home with a right hand. Give and go, done almost as good as you can. And it's 35-31, Northeastern back up by four. Brown off the double staggered high screen, backing up from the lane towards the wing, dishing to the foul line, Nicholas. Nicholas head fake, now elevates and hits, 15-footer. Got the defender in the air and then a little fadeaway, high release jump shot, and it's 35-33. That's a shot Nicholas hit twice early but missed down the stretch of the first half, but showing confidence to keep pulling the trigger. Mercier turns the corner off the dribble, driving down the lane, can't hit, righty runner, too strong off the glass. Nicholas the rebound, outlets it forward to Brown looking to run. Brown left wing, crossing over to the top, into the lane. Right side, banks it up, wouldn't go, but she's fouled and will head to the line for a pair. So Northeastern has already committed as many fouls in 3.5 minutes as they did in the entire first half. 16:26 to go, second stanza. Cassidy Stewart just picked up her second foul, making her third foul, I beg your pardon. And at 35-32, three, two free throws for Erica Brown to try to tie the game. She hits the first, so it's a one-point affair. Elise Mark in for Northeastern. To the bench goes Cassidy Stewart. So one more free throw for Brown. 16:26 left second half, and the New Jersey native converts, and we are tied at 35. So after Northeastern looked like they were going to control the early portion of this second half, it's been Delaware spurting in the right direction. Huskies ball in a tie game. Inside of DeFries on the left block. Offensive foul as she barrels into Erica Brown. Oh, the tough little point guard held her ground and took the charge, and Delaware takes back over with a chance to grab the lead for the first time since it was 4-2, 3 minutes into this game. So here comes Delaware, coming up on 16 minutes left second half. Sire on the dribble towards the right wing, picking up her bounce, feeding inside Caracciolo. A double came, and it was tipped aside. Active help from Hopewell. Oh, they'll say it went off the foot of Caracciolo. Late overrule by the far side official gives it back to Northeastern. Tough break for Delaware. Bad pass there. Sire kind of forcing that with Hopewell just hanging around in the area. Here's a top of the circle dribble. Mercier getting it inside, powering up. Righty finished to freeze. Northeastern back up by two. Sire brings it the other direction. Across the timeline over towards the Delaware bench. Hands it off there to Brown. Brown towards the foul line. Step back, left elbow. Couldn't free herself for the jumper. Kicks it out near corner. Jardine to the foul line. Nicholas hits the 15-footer. Straight away. Toilet bowled at home, and it's 37-37. Here's Northeastern the other way. Up top, DeFries. Right wing, chest pass over Mercier. Mercier looking to get it inside. Can't do it. Instead, up top, finding Hopewell. Hopewell threw it away. Before she did, she walked. Pick your poison. A turnover either direction. Delaware ball when we come back. Again, the Hens a chance to take their first lead since the game's opening minutes. 15:08 to go, second half. We're tied at 37. This is University of Delaware women's basketball on Fox Sports 1290 at 1410 WDOB.
Hello, Delaware fans. This is Coach Brock at beautiful Lums Pond State Park, just minutes from Delaware Stadium. I'm inviting you to come to the park, enjoy their year-round camping, boat rentals, equestrian center, and so much more. While you're here, experience the Go Ape Treetop Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens!
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone. I'm gonna make this place yours.
Exxon and Shell, where the score is tied at 37, 15:08 to go in the second half. Delaware in the first half trailed by as many as 14, but they have stormed back to tie this one. They were down 4 at the break, 6 early in the second half, but a 6-0 spurt from UD, pulling even, and now a chance for Tina Martin's club to take its first lead since the opening minutes of the game, about 2.5 minutes into the contest when it was 4-2. Sire with it, right wing for UD, picking up her bounds, feeding far corner to Nicholas. Nicholas lobbing it inside, right block. Caracciolo spins through a double and is fouled on her way up. And Joy Caracciolo will head to the stripe to shoot a pair. That's a tough angle pass there. Nicholas on the baseline, lobbing it to the block to Caracciolo with not a lot of space in between. It brought the double over, but Caracciolo knew where she wanted to go with it and immediately spun towards the rim. And as a result, the help side defender was late. First free throw for Caracciolo, rattles around and in. And Delaware has its first lead since the opening moments of the game at 38-37. One more free throw coming for Caracciolo, who's now hit 2 of 3 for the game. It's 60% for the season. Second foul shot up, and that one's good. 39-37 Delaware, 14-52 left second half. Hens trying to dig in and continue to get it done defensively. Left wing dribble, it's Mercier. Mercier trying to get it inside for Hopewell. Can't, instead finds her on the perimeter. She dribbles into the lane, lost it, batted it outside. Good job to stick with it, found Mercier. Mercier feeding left baseline to Hopewell. Hopewell drives and double dribbles. Picked up her bounce and then put a second hand on the ball, put it back on the deck, and that gives it to UD. 14-29 left, second half, ends up 2 with the ball and momentum. Sawyer, running point, has done a good job playing with 3 fouls in the second half. Had the 1 turnover, but has really done a good job getting Delaware's offense set. Here's Brown from Sawyer to the foul line. Pull-up jumper off the mark. Couldn't get the roll from about 15 feet. Rebound Mark, wants to run the other way. Racing into the forecourt, feeding a trailing Hopewell. Left wing to Mercier with a little space. Back to Hopewell up top. Right wing Mark, line drive 3. Back rim no. Great box out. Jardine pulls down the weak side board. Outlets it up to Brown, wanting to run, no numbers. Slows it up, feeds it far corner to Sager. High post Caracciolo, inside to Nicholas. Bobbled it, got it back. Fired up a jumper and hits. 41-37 UD, a 10-0 run for Delaware. 13:40 left to go in the second half. All of a sudden, the ball movement much more crisp from UD. They get better looks, pretty open shots, and all within their range. Lob inside, bad pass, thrown away. DeVries tried to force it to Hopewell, no shot whatsoever. And threw it to the baseline, back to Delaware. The ball will go. Sire will head to the bench for a breather. Courtney Green returning for UD. Back for Northeastern, Francesca's Sally. As DeFries, who just turned that ball over, will go take a seat. Kelly Cole stopping her on the sideline, saying that's just not a pass that you can make. Too much traffic and too tough an angle to try to fit it through. Green with it, left wing, up top to Nicholas. Nicholas right wing, handoff to Jardine. Dribbles back between the rings. Left wing give to Green. Green up top to Brown. The pass knocked away into the backcourt. That allows Brown to chase it down. 12 of the timer. She brings it across the timeline. Right wing bounces, bumped, and the foul called on Elise Mark. Mark fouling Erica Brown. Again, that hesitation dribble.
creating the quandary for the defense. This time turning it into the first foul on Mark. Already the sixth team foul on Northeastern in less than 7 minutes. Delaware has none. You wonder if the officials will even that up at some point here. Brown with it. Right wing got away with a bit of a walk as she dragged the pivot. Got it inside to Nicholas. Turn and face from the block off the mark. Offensive board. Caracciolo had a layup. Instead kicked it out to Brown. She drives to the foul line and banks it home straight away in the lane. 43-37 UD up by six. Their largest advantage of the game. Boy, Caracciolo gave up a layup, but not a bad person to get it in the hands of. Erica Brown's hot. Left wing Mark. Right through the defense to the basket, plus a foul. She banks it in with a lefty finish. Hens were a little late rotating. The ball went to the corner, extra feed to the wing. And then I like what Mark did there. Read that Delaware was prone defensively. Instead of pulling the trigger on the jumper, she went right to the basket and drew the foul. It's called on Erica Brown, her first, team's first. Caracciolo will go out. Leon comes back. Also in Sager as Makeda Nicholas will head to the bench. So the lineup now for UD, it's Sager at point, Brown the two, Green moves to the three, Jardine the four, Leon the center. Free throw is good. The lead cut in half for Delaware as Northeastern crawls to within 43-40. Here's Sager walking it across the midcourt stripe. Started right now, angles left to the wing. Changes direction back to the top of the circle. Green coming off the screen. Can't get it to her now. Jardine, the second man, through at the foul line. Couple of dribbles. Up top, Leon. Miss Sager on a backdoor cut. Right wing feed over to Brown instead. Drives left of the lane. Out left elbow to Jardine. Jumper off the mark. Leon tipped the rebound. It goes off the fingertips of Northeastern, but then saved in by Hopewell, who feeds it forward to Mark. Mark finds Mercier on the left wing. 11:55 left, second half. Delaware 43, Northeastern 40, but the Huskies with the ball. Hopewell, good entry feed to Sally. Draws a double, kicks it out to Taggart. Up top to Mark. Mark had it knocked free, chased it down, lobbed it far corner. Mercier doesn't shoot the ball, instead drives. What a finish! Splitting a double, and a tough banker makes it a one-point game, 43-42. Boy, that was nice. 11:30 left, second half. Mercier does have some quickness, fifth-year senior. Quebec native, second team all-conference a year ago. Brown off the bounce, step back, jumper from the right elbow wouldn't go. Rebound tipped by Sager in amongst the trees, but Sally sprawling to the floor, grab it for Northeastern. Outlets it forward to Mercier on the run. To Taggart, left wing, good job to get out on her. Up top to Sally, wide open inside Hopewell, and Leon called for the foul, trying to recover. And to the line to shoot a pair, it'll be Northeastern as this game continues to be an affair of runs. Delaware had a 12-0 spurt. Northeastern has scored five straight points and now two more free throws coming when we return to try to take the lead. It's the Hens 43, Northeastern 42. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
Hey fans, 12 and younger. Do you want to be a future Blue Hen? Join the Future Hens Club presented by St. Francis Healthcare for invites to exclusive events and free admission to select UD games.
Meet coaches and players like us.
Get your official Future Hens t-shirt and more surprises.
To join, log on bluehens.com with a parent, click on Fan Zone, then Kids Club. Click Register Here, fill out your information, and click Submit.
Join today!
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
Welcome back to the Carpenter Center in Newark. Delaware 43, Northeastern 42. Delaware women's basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV, being brought to you by the Glasgow Medical Aid Units, making a difference one patient at a time over 60,000 times a year with locations in Glasgow, Christiana, and Middletown. Same time, save money, get well. Visit them online at glasgowmedicalcenter.com. 11:07 left in this second half. As I said, Northeastern deficit is one, but at the free throw line to try to give the Huskies the lead is Tanisha Hopewell. The senior, who hails from Upper Marlboro, Maryland, will miss the first free throw badly. Pinned it between the backboard and the right of the rim. It falls off that side. One more foul shot coming. Chance to tie the game. Hopewell, just a 55% free throw shooter on the season, puts the second up and through. I don't know how you line those two foul shot attempts up other than lack of concentration on the first. She almost missed the rim and then had perfect form the second time around. We're knotted at 43. A new game, 11 minutes to go. Delaware the ball, high post, Sire. Great feed to Caracciolo. One hard dribble and then a lefty bank. 45-43. Delaware up two. Boy, Jody Sire picked up that silly foul in the first half and has had a turnover or two that you would like to see her avoid, but she continues to really do a nice job getting Delaware in its offense. Here's a lob inside. Sally tried to seal Caracciolo. Caracciolo forced a tough angle finish, but offensive rebound. Hopewell fouled on the putback try, and she'll head to the line again to shoot two. Boy, that was pretty good defense by Caracciolo, as Sally's a big body inside frame that's tough to kind of power against. Sally sealed her, but Caracciolo held her own, forced her almost under the backboard. The angle prevented the initial finish, but weak side rebound for Hopewell. She back rims the first free throw, and the lead stays at two for Delaware. One more foul shot coming for Tanisha Hopewell. Hopewell, player that her head coach, Kelly Cole, says has just a very good work ethic. She said one of the strongest hard-nosed players on the team, but misses a pair of free throws here. Brown the rebound. Here she comes the other way to Green, right wing. Head fake to three. Left elbow give to Nicholas. Open jumper in and out. Another offensive board back for Caracciolo. Feeds it to Nicholas at the free throw line. Moves to right of the lane. Threw it away, but Green swooped in out of nowhere to steal it back. And then Courtney Green is fouled. And a one-and-one coming for Delaware, who all of a sudden beginning to out-hustle the Huskies. That ball was taken away by Northeastern, but Green was going to the basket and found a way to just rip it free and grab it back. Sire will head out for Delaware. Hannah Jardine returning for the Hens. Tanisha Hopewell called for her third foul, so she'll head to the bench as well. First free throw good, so Green will get one more. It's Elise Mark back in for Northeastern. So the Huskies have DeFreeze, Sally, and Taggart in the front court. Mark and Mercier in the back court. Two free throws good. 47-43. Delaware back up by four. 10 1/4 minutes remaining in this second half. Mercier into the forecourt for Northeastern. Started right, now turns back towards the top of the key. Left wing give goes over to Mark. Mark jab step towards the top of the key now as she puts it on the deck. Gives it there to DeFreeze. Right wing feed to Mercier. Threw it to a vacated corner. Taggart was headed towards the basket. Mercier thought she was going to stay still, and a turnover gives it back to Delaware. So that's a team that has just one conference win, one road victory all year long, and is showing off why. Completely unforced error. Now a nickel dime foul caught away from the ball against Northeastern, and that's going to send Courtney Green to the line for a 1-1. Hens will take that all day. Green almost 80% from the free throw line on the season, well over 80% from the stripe as a Blue Hen in her career. Line left, first foul shot good, so she'll get another. 48-43, trying to equal the largest lead of the game for UD if she can knock down this free throw. Green now 7 points on the night, make it eight as she hits a pair. 49-43, 9:47 left second half. Hens holding a 6-point edge. Northeastern the ball in need of a basket. Mercier high post to DeFreeze on the right elbow. Outside to Sally, top of the key. Left wing over to Mark. Lobbing it inside, trying to go to work there. It's DeFreeze, powers up. Lefty banker, too strong. Good rebound in traffic, too, pulled down by Caracciolo. Outlets it up to Brown. Brown into the forecourt. Foul line right, stops, picks up her bounce. Feeds up top to Caracciolo, whose pass is kicked aside. Sally doing her best Ron Hextall impersonation, and she made the kick save at a butte up into her hand. That keeps possession with Delaware. 20 on the timer. Baseline left inbound. Far corner feed to Nicholas. Right wing dish goes to Green. Outside to Brown for the reset. Brown calls the offensive play. Starts left, now turns back right on a crossover move. Nicholas flashes to the block, now out to the corner, gets it, looks, Jardine off his screen, bobbled it, got it back, four to shoot, out to Green, wide open, left wing, three, off the mark, weak side rebound, Nicholas tipped it, but Taggart grabbed it, Taggart feeds it forward to Mark for Northeastern, the other way, stopping left wing, trying to get it inside, can't, instead trying to drive past Brown, can't do that either, gives it off to Sally, no defense there, Sally goes straight to the basket, and banks at home, and Northeastern back to within four. Not sure what happened to the Delaware defense. Kind of fell asleep on rotation, and it was an unimpeded path to the basket for Francesca Sally. Brown dribbling right wing for UD, picking up her bounce, feeding it top of the circle to Jardine, reverses it left wing to Green. High screen comes from Caracciolo, Green uses it, dribbles towards the top, now passes inside to Joy. Joy feeds it up top to Nicholas, deep jumper wouldn't go, maybe a step outside her range. And a rebound corralled by Mercier. Lobs it forward to Mark. Mark passed up an open three. Thought she double dribbled. She put it on the deck. I guess it was a bobble. Missed the mid-range jumper, though. Brown the rebound. Brown the other way. Left. Now right. Back left. Missed the floater. Back rimmed it. Rebound Northeastern. They want to go the other direction. Brown pulls it away from her. Steals it clean and then is caught for stepping on the sideline. And it'll go back to Northeastern. An outstanding effort from Erica Brown, who missed the runner in tight, but then hustled it back down and at least prevented a fast break opportunity for the Huskies. We have a timeout on the floor, 7:54 to go in the second half. It's Delaware 49, Northeastern 45. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 at 1410 WDOV.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
Rush hour or relax hour? It's your choice. Dark. Moving forward.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
.750 and ticking. Northeastern ball out of the media timeout. They trail Delaware by four. Huskies moving left to right in the second half. DeFreeze top of the circle for Northeastern. Right wing feed over to Mercier. Northeastern led by as many as 14 in the opening half. Delaware's been up by as much as six in the second stanza. Right wing over to Mark with eight to shoot. Mark looking inside, can't get it to DeFreeze. Instead up top, Mercier driving at her shot, rejected. Swatted to the baseline by the helping Makeda Nicholas. Her third block of the game. It goes out of bounds. It'll stay with Northeastern with two to shoot. What a block though by Nicholas. And now it's a catch and shoot pretty much situation for Northeastern. They get it to Mark, quick release off the mark with a jumper. Rebound batted out of bounds off the fingertips of DeFreeze. And it'll go to Delaware as a result. So a nice job defensively there by the Hens, digging in out of the media timeout. And now it's Delaware basketball, 7.25 minutes left to go. UD's lead is 49-45, I beg your pardon. Green on the left wing, dribbling towards the corner, near side of the floor. Up top, Caracciolo, a jab step, now a right-hand bounce right of the lane towards the basket. Can't get the finger roll, try to go. Little too strong off the glass. Rebound Northeastern. Mercier looking to push. Feeds to DeFreeze. And DeFreeze slows things up. High left wing feed over to Mark. Nice job to pull it in with one hand. Over her head to grab it. She tipped it in the air to herself. Taggart gets it right wing. Inside to Sally. Spinning on Caracciolo. They call a foul on Joy Caracciolo. Tough call against UD. Sally looked like she did, I don't even know how to describe it, some sort of a quick moving dance with her feet before she went up with a shot, maybe an Irish jig or something. Either way, they call phantom contact on Joy Caracciola, who had initially been standing a couple steps away from Sally. And Joy asking the official, how'd she cover the ground to get to me. First free throw, though, good for Sally. She'll get one more. 72% free throw shooter on the season, who had a double-double against Delaware the first time these teams matched up. She hits a pair here. It's 49-47. Sally has 7 points, 5 rebounds tonight. 6:35 and ticking left second half. UD with the ball up two. Brown top of the circle on the bounce. Feeding left elbow to Green. Lobs it near baseline to Caracciolo. She tries to drive to the basket. Spins it back outside. Gives it off to Green. Green is hand checked by Mercier. Little arm bar call. Mercier agrees. Nods at the official. And it'll be another trip to the line for Courtney Green. Ninth team foul. So the last of the one-on-ones coming for the junior, who hails from Virginia. Green has had a good second half. Slow start to this game, but has gotten to the line and has made all 7 of her free throws as she hits the front end here. 50-47, Delaware back up by 3, 6:21 to go. Hens trying to get above 500 for the first time all season in conference play, back to 500 overall on the year. Green misses the second free throw, and Nicholas got away with an over-the-back, almost pulled down the offensive board, but it ends up in the paws of Mercier. And the fifth-year senior brings it across near corner to Taggart. Hit a first-half three, doesn't pull the trigger here. Instead, up top, Mercier. Left wing over to Marr. Far corner feed to DeFreeze. DeFreeze lobs it between the rings to Mercier. Right wing to Taggart. Tried the extra feed, but Caracciolo there and ready. Knocked it aside to the sideline. And out of bounds. 8 on the timer. 5:58 left, second half. Northeastern will throw it in near sideline, even with the three-point arc. Taggart to get it in to Mercier. Mercier needs to attack off the dribble, does. Drives, draws the defense, kicks it out to DeFreeze. Left elbow, jumper, good. Tough angle line drive shot that was contested, still fell. And Northeastern back to within one at 50-49. Hens just can't get the Huskies to go away. Brown between the rings. Right hand bounce towards the wing. Looking inside for Nicholas, can't get it to her. Instead, up top to Jardine. Jardine, left-hand bounce towards the near wing. Hands it off there to Green. Up top to Nicholas, lobbing it inside. Caracciolo, one bounce up and kissing it home with a righty finish. 52-49, Delaware back up three. 5:18 left. Good high-low game there. Nicholas to Caracciolo. Inside this time, it goes to Sally out to Taggart for three and the tie. No, front rimmed it, but a nice board swooping in to grab it out of nowhere was DeFreeze. She resets it outside to Mercier. 23 to shoot, 5 minutes left. Step back, foot on the line, two is a swish. Straight away off the dribble, Mercier pulls Northeastern to within one. What a finish there from MNC Mercier. Delaware having some problems stopping her, although that's something we've seen over the years from a lot of teams. 15 now for the game for Mercier. Brown looking for an answer off the dribble, driving into the lane and scoops it home with a righty kiss. 54-51, UD by three. Mercier sprinting the other way, got hit by Brown, no call, and then a foul on the rebound against Northeastern. Oh, Brown swooped in, but was shielded from the official. Looked like she bumped Mercier in the side as MNC went up with a shot. Officials did not see it as it was well angled by Brown. And then a rebound grab by Nicholas, who was fouled by Francesca Sally. Sally's second, team's 10th, so we walked the length of the floor. Double bonus time for Delaware. Up by three, Makeda Nicholas at the stripe for a pair. First free throw, good. It's 55-51, 4:29 left in this second half as Leon will return, as will Sawyer. To the bench goes Caracciolo and Green. Back in for Northeastern, Tanisha Hopewell, as Sally will take a seat. One more foul shot coming for Nicholas. Line left. Freshman's had a good game. Three block shots, made a couple of early jump shots, and a free throw rattles out. Still 13 points now for Makeda Nicholas. Here's Northeastern the other direction, dribbling it forward. Here's Mercier, running point, picking up her bounce right wing. Brown all over her. Double bounce pass over to Mark. Mark dribbles towards the left wing, 4.25 minutes left. Feeding it far corner to Taggart. Up top, Mercier, right wing over to Hopewell. Near corner to Mark. Mark driving into the lane, kicking it out. Taggart wide open, triple, good. And we are tied it, or make that a one-point game, I beg your pardon, at 55-54. The three from Taggart, pulling Northeastern to within one. My mistake. Still a little closer than comfort for Delaware. Sire on the right wing, feeding between the circles to Brown. Brown left wing, bounce towards the wing. Looking inside for Leon, instead up top to Nicholas. Lobbing it far corner, Sire. Sire, left hand bounce towards the foul line. Out left wing, Brown. Brown, a couple of bounces, feeds it back to Sire. Cutting into the lane and can't float it over the front of the rim. But offensive board tipped to Nicholas and a reset on the perimeter to Brown. Good hustle from UD. They looked like the team that wanted it more that time. Now they have to make something of it. Tina Martin going to take a timeout. That shows you how pivotal this possession is. Delaware up 55-54. 3:21 to go in the second half. We'll take it with the Hens head coach. Hens up a point with the ball when we return on Fox Sports 1290 at 1410 WDOV.
Delaware Athletic sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
Rush hour or relax hour? It's your choice. Dark. Moving forward.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
Carpenter's center, 3 minutes, 21 seconds left to go in the second half. A close game as Delaware up by only one over Northeastern. Tina Martin taking a timeout as Delaware grabbed an offensive board and now an opportunity to try to pad this narrow edge. Immediate timeout coming up at the next whistle, but I still think a good timeout from Coach Martin has two remaining. And if the Hens can get a score here, strategic control of the game is in their hands, but a stop and Northeastern can take a lead with any type of score. Brown with it, right wing for Delaware, off the inbound, top of the circle to Green. Green calling for a screen from Nicholas, gets it straight away, dribbles towards the left wing, now going baseline, turned back by Taggart, up top to Jardine. Jardine driving right of the lane, picked up her bounce, in some trouble, feeds it left block, Nicholas, lefty, bank, got the roll. Looked like she'd be blocked by the rim, but somehow it flipped up and over the top, and it's 57-54, UD back up by three. 2:50 left on the clock. Mercier looking for an answer. She leads Northeastern with 15. Up top, finding Mark. Mark off the bounce, dishing left wing. DeFreeze. DeFreeze had it knocked aside by Nicholas as she tried to go up. Another block for Delaware. Hens ball. 2:30 left, up by three. Another big possession for UD, trying to get this to a two-possession game. Brown top of the circle, off the bounce, looking for Green. Bounce pass to her left elbow. Lob tip, but into the hands of Caracciolo. Now feeding left elbow. Nicholas going to work. Up and under. Great move. Righty finish. What a finish off the up and under move from Makeda Nicholas. 59-54. Delaware on top by five. Boy, Nicholas just showing off the array of post moves. What a game she has had. Career high 17. Here's Mercier driving. Can't finish. Too strong off the glass with a righty try. Rebound Brown and a chance to work some clock. 1:45 to go. Brown slowly but surely walks it across the timeline. Angling towards the near sideline. Now turns direction. Moving right wing. In front of the Delaware bench. 13 to shoot. Brown, chest pass between the rings to Green straight away. Left wing bounce towards the baseline. Turned back by Taggart. Inside, Caracciolo, right hand. Scooper good! 61-54, Delaware. Six straight out of the media timeout. Here's Northeastern, big three. DeFreeze needs it, can't get it. Rebound, Caracciolo, 1:10 to go. Delaware up 61-54. Brown fouled in the backcourt. And after the media timeout, it'll be two free throws for UD. A 6-0 spurt, a 7-point lead, and things looking good for Delaware, trying to get above 500 for the first time this season in conference play. We'll take a break. Back with a finish in a moment. Hens by 7. You're listening to Delaware Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 at 1410 WDOV.
Hello, Delaware fans. This is Coach Brock at beautiful Lums Pond State Park, just minutes from Delaware Stadium. I'm inviting you to come to the park, enjoy their year-round camping, boat rentals, equestrian center, and so much more. While you're here, experience the Go Ape Treetop Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens!
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone. Cause I'm gonna make this place your
Forget coming up after the game, the American Spirit post-game show brought to you by the American Spirit Federal Credit Union in Newark, Middletown, and Dover, online at americanspirit.org, right here on Fox Sports 1290 at 1410 WDOV, where Delaware leads Northeastern 61-54, 108 to go at the line. Erica Brown misses the first free throw. Still one more coming, though, for the sophomore point guard for UD, and she connects on that one. 62-54, Makeda Nicholas, a career-high 17 points, leading the way for UD. Mercier racing it the other direction for Delaware, driving to the lane, kicking it out to Taggart, right wing to Freeze, head fake to three. She moves to the paint, out to Taggart, straightaway triple, front rim, no, rebound, Caracciolo, under a minute to go. Hens lead is 8. They've scored the game's last 7 points. Brown weaves through traffic and is finally fouled just across the midcourt stripe. Erica Brown to the line for 2 more. She has 11. 4 Hens in double figures. And again, even on a night where the Hens didn't have their best offensive game, going to be in the mid-60s. They're going to have 4 different players eclipsing 10 points. Balanced effort. One player standing out. This is the sign of a young team really growing up. They did not play well at all in the first half as Brown hits the first free throw, but they survived it. And then they thrived here in this second stanza, especially late. And they closed out both halves very strong. Brown hitting the first free throw. Second one, good. First double-digit lead of the game for Delaware. It comes with 49 and 5/10 seconds left. 64-54. Mark racing the other way, barreling into Brown. They call a foul on Erica Brown. Well, it looked like a clear charge. Looked like a lower of the shoulder directly into the chest of Erica Brown. Not a spot where Brown probably should try to take a charge, up 10 with 44 seconds to go, but did seem like she did it successfully. Unfortunately, though, she is called for the foul. 2 free throws coming here as a result for Elise Mark. Chance to get her team back to single digits, but they need a lot more than that. Down 10, 44 and a 10th second left. First free throw gets the roll at 64-55. Northeastern still has 4 timeouts left if they want to try to extend this. And I'd imagine, especially if Mark makes this free throw, they will. I'd call timeout to set up pressure. They make the second. Kelly Cole says no. The pressure is set up. It's a 1-2-2 look. They try to deny. Green popped wide open. Brown waited, got it to her, and she's fouled in the backcourt. Fouled by Mercier, so again we'll walk the length. And Courtney Green will head to the stripe to shoot 2, as Northeastern has been in the double bonus for some time. Remember, early in this game, Northeastern was red hot, over 65% with about 5 minutes to go in the first half from the field. They're all the way down to 47%, just 21 of 45 overall. Delaware at 41% from the field, as Green's first free throw is good. The Hens have converted on 17 of 21 free throws. Makeda Nicholas goes out to a well-deserved round of applause, including a standing O from some of the UD faithful, as the freshman had her best game in her Delaware career. Green hits a second, and a lead back up to 66-56. Mark the other way, drives, had it knocked aside by Caracciolo. It goes to the baseline. Northeastern will throw it in, 37 and 8, 10 seconds left. 17 for Nicholas. 13 for Brown, 12 for Green, 17 for Caracciolo. Inbound, up top to Freeze. DeFreeze pushing off on Green, spinning to the basket, banks it home. And it's back to 8 at 66-58. We'll see if Northeastern will foul again. Into Caracciolo, they will. Joy will head to the line for two more, 32 and 3 tenth seconds. They stop the clock. And two foul shots coming for the senior Boston College transfer. Ends up 8. Should be able to salt this one away. Fourth foul called on Cassidy Stewart. Nicholas had gone over the table, was going to come back, but instead she'll head to the bench. And they'll leave the five on the floor for UD. Sager, Brown, Green, Jardine, and Caracciolo. First foul shot for Joy, good. 18 points for Joy Caracciolo. She has had a magnificent night as well. 7 of 14 shooting. She's 3 of 4 at the stripe, 10 rebounds. Pretty good. Second foul shot for Caracciolo. That one rattles out. And it's 67-58. Northeastern the rebound. Down 9, but they need threes. They need them in a hurry. And instead, they're going to drive. Mercier in some trouble. Picked up her bounce. Hit a backdoor cutting to Freeze, who finishes with the left hand plus the foul. Silly foul. We'll see who it's on. Cuts it to a 7-point game. Give the personal to, I believe, Erica Brown. Team's sixth. Joy Caracciolo will check out for UD, replaced by Makeda Nicholas. But it is a chance to get it back to two possessions here for Northeastern if DeFreeze can hit the foul shot. It's up and good, 67-61. I wonder if Northeastern's flying out tonight. Evidently, Kelly Cole has a flight to catch because she is not calling timeouts to try to set anything up. Jardine spins out of a double, feeds it forward to Brown. Brown is fouled across the midcourt stripe. And even one free throw here will get this back to a three-possession game. Boy, I've never seen a coach not call a single timeout in the second half when a team has spurted on him on several different occasions. Surprising that Cole would let Northeastern play on. In her first season, then an uneven opening campaign in Boston. They're going to fall to 4-17 on the year, 1-10 in conference as Brown hits the first free throw. Delaware with the win will move to 11-11 overall and is 6-5 in the league. One more free throw coming line left for Brown, but it's back to a three-possession game. It's 68-61. Second foul shot off the mark. Rebound thrown away. Northeastern grabbed it, and DeFreeze, her outlet too tall for Mark, out of bounds. Delaware ball, and I'd imagine Northeastern at this point probably let him dribble it out. The inbound goes in the backcourt to Brown. Mark is going to chase her, see if she gives the foul. Brown spins away from her, crosses over, and Mark does give the personal with 9 4/10 left. Brown will take it. Chance to go to the stripe and pad her stats. Erica Brown with 14 in the game. Has averaged better than 20 per contest over the last 7 affairs. And is the reigning CAA player of the week. Remember, Brown had 31, a career high last time out. Brown hits the first free throw. Boy, Delaware, if Brown knocks down this foul shot, will end up with 70 points, which means they've eclipsed the 70-point mark 4 times in their last 5 games. And it's good, so they have done it. 70-61, Delaware's lead back to 9. Northeastern one last shot try as Mark brings it up, fires a 3 straight away, off the mark, rebound batted, loose in the corner, saved by Taggart. She's on the line. They could have let it go. Instead, we'll get an inbound with 8/10 of a second left. But that just extends the celebration for UD. They throw it in, and a buzzer sounds, and Delaware has won this game. They storm back from what was a 14-point first-half deficit, and they beat Northeastern by a final score of 70-61, closing the game out on a 15-5 run. Day 2 coming up from the Carpenter Center. We'll hear from Tina Martin, plus our player of the game as the Hens win it 70-61. The American Spirit post-game show in a moment.